Yes, Pia, I've been talking to some of the anti-Marcos protesters here at the People Power Monument. Obviously, they're very upset over the sudden burial of late President Ferdinand Marcos. Basically, they've shouted all kinds of chants from Marcos no hero, diktador, magnanakaw, hukayin, Marcos Duterte, taksil sa bayan, among others. They decry what they say is the burial of truth and justice along with the remains of the former president. They also sang Bayan Ko to express their anger, disappointment, and frustration over the said burial. They've been here since 3 p.m. At least 500 of them are here, according to the police. Most of them are wearing black, but according to the protesters, they're already here at about 3:05, and the protest was organized in a snap on social media after reports rang out that Marcos will finally be buried at the Libingan. The venue is also symbolic since this is one of the flashpoints of the 1986 EDSA revolution that deposed the former president. Now they're back here against the same person and against the same reason to call for justice for Marcelo victims. And now here with me is one of the sponges, anti-Marcos activist Jim Paredes. Jim, good evening.
Good evening.
Basically, what is your initial reaction after you've heard that Marcos is set to be buried at the Libingan?
Initial shock, then immediate outrage. I really felt na the burial, which was a sneak burial. It wasn't like a hero's burial at all. Parang it was just inserted there. Napakahayop na ang ginawa nila. I really felt that it was an insult to the Filipino people. I felt it was a denial of the whole EDSA experience. It was a denial that people were tortured, people died, na nagnakaw sila. It was a denial na the Marcos era was one of the worst things that we went through as a people. For him to be buried in Libingan ng mga bayani.
Basically, what are anti-Marcos groups planning to do now that Marcos is already 6 feet down under?
You know, this is so sudden. I tweeted this at 1 o'clock. By 2 o'clock, I was leaving the house to come here. I don't even know who the organizers are. I met some of them. This is practically almost spontaneous. Somebody mentioned People Power Monument, so everybody gathered here. I understand there are other areas that they went to, like Ateneo, UP, Ayala Circle, Lasal, and others, but I don't know who's leading this. This is spontaneous, but in the next few hours, I'm sure this is going to be more concerted.
Now that Marcos is finally buried at the Libingan, what do you want the Marcos family to do? Do you want an apology, and what kind of apology?
You know, this is not over. This is certainly far from over. What they want is for us to forget and move on. Now, can they tell that to the families who still cannot find their children or their uncles and fathers who were killed before? Can you tell that to people who are still paying for the plunder that they did? Can you tell that to the people who were tortured? No? What, forget? I call that cheap forgiveness. If they really, really want to ask for forgiveness, return the money, itemize everything that they did, tell the people they will not run for public office, and maybe we can forgive.
Jim, thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.
That was Jim Paredes, one of the staunchest anti-Marcos activists. Now, on the security situation, we've seen at least 3 dozens of policemen guarding the area. So far, there's no any untoward incident recorded on the traffic situation. The White Plains Avenue and the northbound lane of EDSA are still passable to traffic, while the protests here are expected to last until late in the evening. Pia.
Gretz Remedio reporting from the People Power Monument. A strongly worded statement from